Now next result is, let N and N dash be a non-linear space and T is a linear mapping from N to N dash. If dimension of N is finite, then T is a bounded operator. So this is again very important result. So we already proved that in a finite dimensional vector space, in a finite dimensional non-linear space, all the norm are equivalent. So remember that result. In finite dimensional non-linear space, all the norms are equivalent. Now in this result, the given part is T is mapping from N to N dash, and that is a linear transformation, and dimension of N is finite. Then our purpose is to prove that T is continuous or bounded. Now in the given part, this N and N dash, this is a non-linear space and T is a linear transformation. So this is a linear transformation. This is a linear transformation, right? Let T is linear transformation. Now in the given part, dimension of N is finite. Dimension of N is finite. So we say that this is equal to N. Suppose this term is equal to N. If a dimension is N, then it has basis of N vectors. So let I take this E1, E2, and so on up to En. So this is a basis of a normed linear space, normed linear space N, right? So if dimension is N, so this is a basis. If this is a basis, then every vector of N can be expressed as the linear combination of these vectors. Now for every X belongs to N, there exists a scalars alpha 1, alpha 2, so on up to alpha n, such that this X can be written as summation of alpha I e I is running from 1 to n, right? And this expression is unique. So remember that this expression is unique because e1, e2, en is a basis. If it is a basis, and since T is a linear transformation, the linear map, so T of X can be written as T of alpha 1 E1 alpha 2 E2 plus alpha n En. Since it is a linear transformation, so this is a alpha 1 T of E1 plus alpha 2 T of E2, so on, plus alpha n T of En, right? So this value can be written as, which is equal to summation of alpha I T of Ei, where I is running from 1 to n, right? So this is a equation number 2 and this is a equation number 1. Clear? since it is a linear transformation, so we can find the value of t of x. Now, what is the norm of t of x? So norm of t of x, which is equal to norm of summation of alpha I t of e I, where I is running from 1 to n. So this is less than equal to summation of absolute value of alpha I norm of t I, where I is running from 1 to n. So this is a, by using triangle inequality in the norms, because n and n dash are, n and n dash are the norm linear space. So this values, now this value, each alpha is always less than equal to its maximum value. So this can be written as maximum value of alpha I, where for every I, into summation of norm of t I is running from 1 to n, right? So this is a one term and this is a second term. So this is a first term. So what is first term? It is, by definition, it is a zeroth norm of x. If it is zeroth norm of x and this is some constant, so this can be written as small k. If this can be written as small k, so in that case we can write it as norm of tx less than equal to k into norm of x0 for every x belongs to n, where k is equal to summation of norm of t e I, where I is running from 1 to n, right? So this is, it implies this norm is, this norm of t x is less than equal to k time norm of x 0, and it implies t is bounded. So it implies t is bounded. Now we know that this is bounded with respect to zeroth norm. We know that all the norms in finite dimensional space, in finite dimensional space, in the finite dimensional space, all norms are equivalent. If all norms are equivalent, so this can be also bounded by simple norm. So this can be written as norm of tx into less than equal to some constant k dash into norm of x for every x belongs to n. So it implies this t is bounded with respect to norm this, right? And here t is bounded with respect to zeroth norm, with respect to zeroth norm, right? But since all the norms are bounded, so that's why it is also bounded with this norm. So this is very, very important result, and remember that result. After that, the next important result is, next important theorem is, so if M is closed linear subspace of a non-linear space n, and t is a natural mapping of n onto n by m defined by t of x, which is equal to x plus m for every x belongs to n. Show that t is a continuous linear transformation for which norm of t is less than equal to 1. Now we have three part. One part, t is a linear transformation. Second part, it is a bounded. And third part, norm of t is less than equal to 1. So remember all the three values. We already proved that n by m, this is a normed linear space, which is a normed linear space, that we already proved that. And here the definition of norm is x plus m, which is a infimum of norm of x plus small m, such that small m belongs to capital M. And the sum is addition and scalar multiplication is defined as x plus m plus y plus m, and this is equal to x plus y plus m. Similarly, scalar multiplication, alpha x plus m into alpha x plus m, right? So that is to revise the previous concept. Now here we will start our result. Now to prove the linear transformation, let x and y, it belongs to n, right? So to prove the linear transformation, and alpha and beta are scalars, and alpha and beta are scalars. So t of alpha x plus beta y, by definition, this can be written as alpha x plus beta y plus m. So this is by definition. Now using the property of sum, alpha x plus m beta y plus m, right? It implies, now using the property of scalar multiplication, alpha x plus m plus beta y plus m. So this can be written as alpha tx plus beta ty. So that is the proof of first part. It implies t from n to n by m is linear transformation. Linear transformation, right? Now after this, if n to n by m, it is a linear transformation, next step is to prove that it is a bounded, and then our purpose is to prove that it is, its norm is less than 1. Now next step, so this is first step, which is a linear transformation. Second step, to prove that it is a bounded operator. Now norm of tx, this can be written as norm of x plus m, right? By definition, it is a infimum of norm of x plus m, such that small m belongs to capital M, right? And this is less than equal to norm of x plus m for every m belongs to capital M and x belongs to capital N, right? So this value implies. Now what is m? M is a part of capital M, and M is subspace. Since M is subspace, so 0 is also part of capital M because it is a subspace. So it has a determinant. A determinant is 0, so 0 belongs to M. So in particular, if I take M is equal to 0, in particular case, if I take small m which is equal to 0, so the given equation will become Tx which is less than equal to norm of x for every x belongs to n, right? Here k is equal to 1, so T is bounded operator. So here T is bounded operator, the bounded linear transformation. Now second part is norm of T is less than equal to 1. So just use the definition of norm of T. So what is norm of T? It has three definitions. We can take any one of them. Supremum of norm of Tx such that norm of x less than 1, this values. Now using this result, suppose this is equation number 4. Using this result, this is less than equal to norm of x. Norm of x is less than equal to 1 and supremum of 1 is again 1. So it implies norm of T which is less than equal to 1, right? So it is a bounded operator as well as norm of T is less than. The result is, if T is continuous linear transformation of norm linear space N into N dash, and if M is null space, then show that T induce a natural transformation T dash of n by m into n dash, and norm of t is equal to norm of t dash. So this is very important result. So first I revise some fundamental that we already learnt in the previous lectures. Now what is m? So first, what is m? So m is a, if m is closed linear subspace of normed linear space N, right? Then N by M is again non-linear space, and it consisting a x plus capital M such that x belongs to N, right? Here this is a non-linear space with the two binary compositions. One is sum, so sum is x plus M plus y plus m, which is equal to x plus y plus m, and second is scalar multiplication, so that is alpha x plus m, which is equal to alpha x plus m, right? So remember that. So this is a previous result that n by m is a norm linear space with these two binary compositions, with these
to addition and binary composition. Now in the given result, what is given? Let T is from N to N dash be a linear transformation. It is a linear mapping, right? If it is a linear mapping and M is null space, so what is M, which is a kernel of T? So this is kernel of T, which consisting all x belongs to N such that its image is equal to 0. So this M is null space of norm linear space, normed linear space N, right? So that is a definition of this. Now we define a new operator, new mapping, which is from N by M to N dash, and whose norm is equal to norm of T. That is my purpose. So to define a one map from N by M, so my purpose is define a map, T dash. This is from N by M to N dash. So this is defined by, so just see how we can define this. Now this is, if N is nonlinear space and this N dash is nonlinear space, so this T mapping is from N to N dash, right? If x vector belongs to N, then T of x vector belongs to N dash. It means the member of N dash is TX type and member of N is X type. So we define this map as T dash, and what is its member? X plus M, which is equal to T of X for every X belongs to N, right? Because this is a element of, this is a vector of N dash, and this is a vector of N by M. So we define in this way. So we, our purpose is to prove three result. Number one, it is a linear transformation. Number two, it is a bounded. And number three, its norm is with norm of T dash is equal to norm of T. So step number one, my purpose is it is a linear transformation. So I take two vector x plus m and y plus m belongs to N by M, and alpha and beta are scalars. Alpha and beta are scalars. If alpha and beta are scalars, so to prove this is a linear transformation, so I take T dash into bracket alpha x plus m plus beta y plus m, this values. So this value is equal to, this value is equal to T dash bracket by scalar multiplication, it is alpha x plus m and it is beta y plus m. So here I used the scalar multiplication. Now using the sum of these vector, so this will be T dash, which is alpha x plus beta y plus m, this values. Now this value is equal to, by using the definition of T dash, this is T of अल्फा एक्स प्लस बीटा वाई. सिंस टी इज लीनियर ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन सो वी कैन राइट इट एज अल्फा टी एक्स प्लस बीटा टी वाई, राइट. सो दिस इज अल्फा टी एक्स प्लस बीटा टी वाई. अगेन यूजिंग द डेफिनेशन ऑफ टी डैश, सो दिस इज अल्फा टी डैश एक्स प्लस एम प्लस बीटा इंटू टी डैश वाई प्लस एम, राइट. सो हेयर वी प्रूव दैट टी डैश फ्रॉम एन बाय एम टू एन डैश इज ए लीनियर मैप. सो दिस इज ए लीनियर मैप. सो दैट इज माई फर्स्ट स्टेप. नाउ सेकेंड स्टेप इज टू प्रूव नॉर्म ऑफ टी एंड नॉर्म ऑफ टी डैश इज इक्वल, राइट. सो वी नो दैट फॉर एवरी एक्स बिलोंग्स टू एन वी नो दैट नॉर्म ऑफ एक्स प्लस एम बाय डेफिनेशन इट इज ए इनफीमम ऑफ नॉर्म ऑफ एक्स प्लस स्मॉल एम सच दैट दिस स्मॉल एम बिलोंग्स टू कैपिटल एम दिस वैल्यूज बिकॉज इट इज ए इनफीमम सो दिस कैन बी रिटन एज नॉर्म ऑफ एक्स प्लस एम फॉर एवरी एक्स बिलोंग्स टू एन एंड एम बिलोंग्स टू कैपिटल एम. व्हाट इज एम? एम इज सबस्पेस ऑफ एन. सो इनडायरेक्ट वे एम इज आल्सो पार्ट ऑफ एन. रिमेंबर दिस. सो इन पर्टिकुलर इफ आई टेक एम इज इक्वल टू जीरो, राइट. सो दिस कैन बी रिटन एज एम इक्वल टू जीरो और इट बिलोंग्स टू एम. सो वाई इट बिलोंग्स टू एम? बिकॉज एम इज सबस्पेस एंड एवरी सबस्पेस हैज़ ए एडिटिव आइडेंटिटी. सो जीरो बिलोंग्स टू दिस. सो इन दिस वे नॉर्म ऑफ एक्स प्लस एम विच इज लेस देन इक्वल टू नॉर्म ऑफ एक्स फॉर एवरी एक्स बिलोंग्स टू एम. सो राइट इट एज इक्वेशन नंबर. हेयर इट इज एज इक्वेशन नंबर वन. सो हेयर इट इज इक्वेशन नंबर टू. सपोज दिस इज इक्वेशन नंबर वन एंड दिस इज इक्वेशन नंबर टू. सो वट इज नॉर्म ऑफ टी डैश विच इज शुड बी इक्वल टू नॉर्म ऑफ टी. सो दैट इज माई पर्पज. नाउ वट इज नॉर्म ऑफ टी डैश? सो नॉर्म ऑफ टी डैश, सो हेयर वी गेट दिस वैल्यूज. सो वट इज फर्स्ट नॉर्म ऑफ टी डैश, देन वट इज नॉर्म ऑफ टी? सो नॉर्म ऑफ टी डैश विच इज इक्वल टू, जस्ट यूजिंग डेफिनेशन, सुप्रीमम ऑफ नॉर्म ऑफ टी डैश एंड एक्स प्लस एम बिकॉज इट्स अ डोमेन इज एन बाय एम सच दैट नॉर्म ऑफ एक्स प्लस एम लेस देन इक्वल टू वन, राइट. सो हेयर एक्स बिलोंग्स टू एन एंड वी नो द एम. नाउ दिस कैन बी रिटन एज, जस्ट सी केयरफुली, बाय यूजिंग द डेफिनेशन ऑफ टी डैश. सो दिस इज इक्वल टू नॉर्म ऑफ टी एक्स, राइट. दिस इज ए नॉर्म ऑफ टी एक्स. रिमेंबर दैट. सच दैट नॉर्म ऑफ एक्स प्लस एम लेस देन इक्वल टू वन एंड फॉर एवरी एक्स बिलोंग्स टू एम. सो दैट इज माई फर्स्ट पार्ट, फर्स्ट वैल्यूज. नाउ आई फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ नॉर्म ऑफ टी. सो वट इज दिस? इट इज ए सुप्रीमम ऑफ नॉर्म ऑफ टी एक्स सच दैट नॉर्म ऑफ एक्स लेस देन इक्वल टू वन, राइट. So see that, and this x is a part of n, means this condition is satisfied for every vector of x. Now x belongs to n, m is part of m, and it is a part of n, so it also belongs to n. N is subspace, so it implies x plus small m belongs to n, right? So in place of x we take x plus m, so this is a supremum of norm of T of x plus m, right? Such that norm of x plus m less than equal to 1 for every m belongs to capital M, right? So this can be written as supremum of norm of Tx plus Tm, right? Such that norm of x plus m less than equal to 1, m belongs to capital N, right? Now, since M is a null space, here M belongs to capital M, which is a kernel of T, it implies T of M is equal to 0, right? So using this concept, we get supremum of norm of Tx such that norm of x plus m less than equal to 1 for every m belongs to capital M, right? So this can be written as supremum of norm of Tx such that norm of x plus m, which is less than equal to 1, right, because m belongs to capital, for every x belongs to n. So suppose this is a equation number b, suppose, right? So this is a value of norm of T. Similarly, we already find the value of norm of T dash. So this is again, suppose this is A, right, and that is B. So just see the value of A, so which is a norm of T dash, supremum of this norm of x plus m less than equal to 1, right? So similarly, you can see the value of a norm of T. So this is again supremum of norm of Tx, norm of x plus m less than equal to 1. So it implies from A and B, norm of T, which is equal to norm of T dash, right? Since this is a bounded operator, so it is also bounded operator with same norm. So which prove this theorem, that is very important result. So in the next lecture, we will prove a very important result. So that is called a Hahn-Banach theorems.